The song really started. We have a really cool, like vintage keyboard, and that synth pattern, that do 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 do, was just a loop, a musical loop that we created, and we just really liked the feel of it. So we had that, and then we passed around the microphone and just tried to come up with some cool melodies over top of it. Yeah. And I mean, we kind of just went from there. Yeah,
I think we wrote the verse melody first, and we took a break, and we were just kind of like whistling the melody around the house because it was just catchy, and we were just and then we were like, all right, well, we should probably track that. Let's just try to throw a whistle in the song, and as like a placeholder, and then ended up kind of just staying in the track.
The label was like, yeah, I'm not to throw them under the bus,
they're here
but
now.
They were like, yeah, are those placeholder? We're like, I don't know, but we think they're kind of catchy, and then we ended up keeping them. So okay. I think it was the right call, but.
It's almost like a hook in and of itself. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we're like, do we need to just really own the whistle and just throw that in all of our tracks from now on? It's like the whistling band, but we can't do that.
Lyrically, it almost feels like a stream of consciousness. Yeah. Did it flow like that naturally when you were putting pen to paper?
Yeah, the lyrics came about super easy. It was definitely kind of stream of consciousness. I mean, the first lyric of the song started. I was inspired by, we were watching an old like home video of Max and I, and we were actually jumping on a trampoline as kids. So that kind of got it started, and then we took it in this different direction and made it more of a dreamlike song.
Yeah, we have a big backyard, so our studio has a big window, so we get to look out on our nice little yard, and so we really tried to integrate like a lot of nature stuff with the song.